And even though they, at first I was thinking, wow, they're a bit hucky, I kind of, I went back to it and panged away at it. And I was kind of, thought, why don't I do that again? And I was like, no, hold on, you don't do things again. And I was like, well, you just did that. And I thought, well, I'll try another one. So I tried another one. And I started becoming more and more realizing that I could change things quite a bit. And I also realized which was a surprise, because in my mind, without the doing, I was thinking, but they will all look the same. But then I was thinking, no, hold on, dude, you're in a position now where you can actually make up different, like put a tanifar in there, you could address some cannibalism, you could look at our own history. This is where I'm at, this is where I came. And so this is what was starting to happen. And all these paintings were done this year or last year. And this one's the newest one, which was done a couple of weeks, it was finished a couple of weeks ago. But the other thing is that there's so many textures to it and already existing things that I knew from learning from that I could play off, and I was really surprised how well it was coming together for me. It really gave me a shock, actually, because like I said, I'd always struggled up until this point of thinking, what am I going to paint next? What's it going to be next? Oh, well, it's going to be this. I'm going to say it's this, but it really wasn't that. And it was this. I can say and feel that it is part of this canoe, river, environment, flooding. They've all got names, but the thing is that I could use that canoe as a platform or an armature to hang off all sorts of things. And by that stage, I was thinking, well, I was thinking, you know, I'm just going to kind of really kind of hang off some feathers, some different feathers. And the same was with, and so with this one here, a person who was actually in the audience said, I'll buy this painting. And that was this painting. Don't touch it. And but the thing is, I work at a pretty fast pace, and I was thinking, I don't like this painting. And even though I've been seduced in the past with, oh, you know, people buy things, but I was thinking, no. So this painting, with lots and lots and lots of paint, again with the blade, really kind of expressive, turned into this painting. And I find that there's layers, I mean, they've all got layers, sure, but there's definitely some, everything's still bunched up here, but at least there's a little bit more space, believe me. But I'm not complaining, and I'm certainly not complaining about the opportunity that the Unitech Painting Program gave me to express my desire to really get into the whole sensation of and the tactileness of painting, really explore it. And with this one here, a lot of it's actually just done with my fingers. Again, existing underneath of paintings. And it's not because I was like hard up for frames, because we've got a good surface where you can make frames, we've got a good surface where you can make a kid canvas, which is, I was also grateful for Unitech to be able to supply that for me. So I could see there was things that were going to hold my attention, and my attention span is not very long. And so, this dude here was cut out, and this dude here was actually a fist from another painting. But this dude, is, to me, it's a person. And I had a lot being able to actually explore every single minute detail. I mean, I have colleagues coming in and giving their and the professors and the students giving their opinions, and I don't know what I'm doing, and I think this is another thing I've learned to chill with, even though I'm a pretty high-strung guy, is that I quite like the fact that I don't know what I'm doing, and because I don't know what I'm doing, I get very surprised, and I like being surprised, and so and also I like making a mess, but through that mess, I'm also getting my mystery sense going, and I like to have this kind of mystery kind of where I can stand. Like, so if it was like drugs, or drugs from the 60s, some real strong drug, where I wouldn't be taking the hallucinogens, but I could get that thing happening along, so it's actually kind of hold me, so I could goof off on things I think I can see, but they're not really there, but maybe there's a suggestion that they are, an ambiguity. And I like that. I don't like having people over the head with too much narrative, like you can make up your own minds about it. But this one here, I really like doing the fact that I could do it with my fingers, and you can see up here, even then, they've been spun around, and they've been or made upside down, because that's the whole process as well for me, is how is it going to be? Is it going to be a square? Is it going to be a rectangle? What is it? How is it going to look? And these are the factors that I've had to bring into account when I've been using the oil sticks. And often with oil sticks, a lot of them, most of them, I have got oil sticks on them as well, incidentally, which the art shop people, anyway, I like to use them with my fingers. That's it. And I don't care what they say, I like to use my fingers, and that's the best way for me. And there's in spray paints, I like just the little lines, and that's it, or just spray paint. But there's many factors to it, and then things that I can add to it, and I just find little areas that are quite lovely and quite beautiful to me, that I can goof off on. And I got into a position where I had time and space as well, which was an odd thing, because I always thought that if I kept on doing different things, then I would be learning. But in actual fact, because I zoned in on this river series and really broke it down, then I could. It was a surprise to me that I started learning more, not tricks, but I just started learning more values that I could bring to each work. Because of that, you can see some radical. This painting here, this painting here is actually this painting here, okay, which was also done a month ago. But the thing is, it's been spun around. You can see some kind of hand there. There's that hand there, and it's spun around, and this is called home. A cool home is based, again, it's based off a work I got off the internet, off that area that I grew up in Wairarapa, and they have a Times Age, which was an avid newspaper I used to love reading as a kid, because they had lots of arcane stories in there, and journalism in those days. But I found this image of a meeting house with some fish, just kind of like this, but I wanted to bring in a ghost factor, and I wanted to bring this unfinished factor into it, and I wanted to make the mind, our brains, or the back of our brains actually start working out this was called white Tanifar. At my time, I was thinking that was the Tanifar. Well, the only thing left of the Tanifar on one level was its teeth. But these characters here, his head is sideways. obviously, because it was that, because it was that way. But it kind of, I like it, and even in the photograph, I find photographs aren't enough for me, and so, but they give me a platform to be able to hang it, another kind of narrative of it in a loose way. And it was called, some people had commented about it on Facebook, this image in their archives, and they said, oh, some people, well, where is this? And I know it's a place called Homebush. That's where it is, Homebush. I know because I grew up in that area, and I was lucky enough to travel around a lot of the country as a child. But I called it home. And to me, it is home. It's come home.